The line on the golf ball, where did it come from? Tiger Woods, that's where it came from. He was one of the first people to draw the line on the golf ball. So guess what? That's what we all did. So for 20 years, most people have been using this and a marker pen. Every Wednesday night on tour, I would get my dozen golf balls, mark them all up for Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday with my marker, but also with the line on the golf ball. Now this is precision. There's nothing more annoying when you got it wrong. It's like £3.30 down the drain. In fact, I remember playing foursomes with Dave Horsey. He said, "We're using your balls, Soph." I said, "Yep." So I threw him a Titleist that I put the line on, and he threw it straight back at me and said, "That line's not straight, I'm not using that." Oh. And the marker pen would kind of wear away sometimes and smudge. So the manufacturers have cottoned on to the fact that the line on the golf ball is very much here to stay. They're doing it for us now, thankfully. So no need for the marker pens anymore. No need for smudged golf balls. Thankfully, they're doing it for us. So these are the golf balls in question. We've got the Callaway Chrome Soft X triple track technology as used by Phil Mickelson. We've got the TaylorMade TP5x Pix with clear path technology designed and used by Ricky Fowler. And Titleist have got on board also with their TruFeel. So this was designed on my Titleist. It was the most popular one that people picked to put on their golf ball. That is why Titleist have put it on the TruFeel also. Now this is not the high performance ball. It's not expensive as the other ProVs, but that's not what this video is about. This video is about alignment. Are these alignment technologies good for your game, and will you hold more putts with them? We're going to do a few different scenarios on the putting green. First of all, five footer up the hill using all the golf balls. So first up, the Pix. Now this has only got kind of one line. It's quite traditional in the sense that of that line with the little arrows, but then you've got the clear path at the side. It's quite a lot going on with this golf ball, but you'll see from the filming of the ball rolling end over end, it does roll, or look to roll, very good. Now for the Callaway, triple track, three lines on this one, and very bold as well, that deep red line there. So I imagine that they're saying to you, focus on the red line. This is your important line. And the other two were just to check that you haven't got it too left or too right. It's hard lining up a golf ball with a line, trust me. I've actually had to book golf lessons on doing that. The Callaway ball almost looks like a putting aid golf ball rather than your regular golf ball that you're going to tee it up with. Remember, these golf balls you've got to use in the entirety of your golf round, not just on these greens. Now for the Titleist TruFeel, a lot less going on here and a lot smaller in profile of the lines. Once again, red, which is going to really focus the mind. You don't notice the lines as much when you're putting, when it rolls. You can hardly see that redness. Now, just a standard ProV1x with the traditional lines. Now, I line up my golf ball anyway, so that's what I'm used to. Very simple, that golf ball. It's just a bright white golf ball with no patterns on it. So far, I think the TaylorMade and the Callaway are a lot easier to line up, but that's because there's so much on there, I think. So that's my findings so far. Now this one is a short putt, but it's breaking a lot. And I think this is where the line really comes into play, because you're not aiming at the hole, you're aiming an inch or two outside of the hole. Now I have used the triple track putter with the triple track ball, and that makes it lining up so much easier. So you're not only lining the ball, you can match your putter face to it as well. I think with the TruFeel, I normally like to, well, thinking that I need to have it on top, but actually I think I need to turn it more towards me like I do when using the regular ProV. Just helps with that lining up a touch more. Oh, just didn't move, still a good putt. That's something to bear in mind. So what I do, I don't put it on top, I turn it more towards me, and I do that so my line matches that line. With the TaylorMade and Callaway, the lines are that long and big, you don't need to do that. Oh, missed two. Now there's a lot going on with the TaylorMade and the Callaway, a lot on the golf ball. If you're not into that and you want a clear surface, that's something that you're going to really have to think about, because when I started using the Pix, just trialing it out, I struggled on hitting my irons with it. It just looked like a football. But that is something that you really need to consider. Do you want a clean ball or do you want the patterns? Now for the longer putt. I think this is where alignment lines on your ball really come into your own. It's hard to get the pace, line, speed, everything with a longer putt. So this is almost ticking off one of those subjects for you. It's nice to have that confidence when you stood over it, just hit through that line. Almost right now, all I'm thinking of is pace. Line is taking care of itself. I do think it's harder to line up the two Titleists because it's such a smaller profile. It does make lining up this ball harder. You see how easy it is to kind of get it that way or that way with this. You can move it this way and this way very easy, as well as that way and that way. I feel like the TaylorMade and the Callaway eliminates this way and this way. A positive that I've found with the Pix, that even when you don't quite strike the putt perfect, that end over end roll, the pattern makes it look like you do. So when I've played with some of my friends, they've gone, "Putt, Soph," and it's not. So it's nice to have that, it looks like a good putt, even if it isn't, and then people saying to you, good putt, because if you keep those affirmations, you're gonna think you're a good putter. So Titleists have almost just dipped their toe into the alignment. Very Titleist this, very clean, just a normal looking golf ball. But Callaway and TaylorMade are a bit out there than Titleist. They've just gone for it, no messing around here. Look at that. It looks like a football almost. And Callaway have obviously done the football look before, and they've gone all out on the line. So whereas Titleist has just gone little, these guys have gone big or go home. I think what these alignment aids do is they stop you just rolling putts willy-nilly. They make you line them up. If you are somebody that needs a line, that struggles with your aiming of the club, these are definitely for you. If you like a clean golf ball and you don't use a line, then stick to the Titleist. I've used a line my entire professional career. I think it's really valuable to me because it becomes, pace is key. I've already sorted the alignment out over the ball, and then I just have to think about the pace. I do think alignment tools, in this case the golf balls, definitely help your putting. Thank you for watching this video. Please click the subscribe button and the like button and comment below. Do you think these alignment balls are just a gimmick or do they really work? The question is, go and try them. Buy a pack of three, go on the putting green, give them a go. Now there's plenty more coming from Golfalot in terms of golf balls in 2020, so stay tuned for that. Thank you very much for watching and I'll see you again next time.